Okay, we're going to be creating a Google form, and we're going to be using something called branching, which is going to control which questions that you see based on the answers that you give to the questions. Let's act like they just took a course, so the first question is we're just going to ask them how they like the course just to get them started. This one is just kind of a warm-up intro question, and this won't be part of the conditional flow. So we're going to have that be our first question in this section. But now we're going to ask a multiple choice question, and the answer to this is going to bring them to a different place. We're going to make sure that it's required, and we'll fill out a couple of options here. So what type of course do they want next? So I gave them two options here, but I want to give them an other option as well. But I don't want to use this pre-configured other option because that will just give them an empty box to type into. I want the other option to bring them to a different place in the form. So I'm going to just add one that says other. And then we'll come back to this when we add the branching and we'll talk about how this is going to lead them to another spot. We'll go down and delete these other questions that were here from the template. And now we'll come over to the right and we're going to left click on add section. And you'll see below it says after section one. Right now, continue to next section is selected as the default. We'll leave that here for a little bit until we build out the rest of this form, and then we're going to come back and customize that. So I already know that the first choice is going to bring them to this section if they want time management courses. And the point of bringing them here is to find out which course that they want. So we'll add a question. And we'll just add two courses that we happen to offer using tasks or using the calendar. If they want something else, let's give them a real other field here. So we'll use the one in blue that Google is suggesting, and they'll be able to type their answer in there. And this section is done. Now we're going to add another section for the human resources courses. And this will just be another multiple choice. All right, so now we have your top question asking which type of course. Then we filled out the two different types. We're going to use those to see which people want our pre-configured courses, or they can type in another in each category. But if they picked other at the very beginning, it may be a different category. So we'll add another section at the bottom. And we're going to make this one a short answer because the point of this is to collect other ideas that they may have. Maybe if you see a lot of suggestions for a similar type of course, you can put that together. So come up, choose short answer. That'll give the user a text field to type in what they want. And then we'll come down to the last section, and this is going to be the follow-up section. And really what you're looking to get out of this form is a way to follow up on leads. So what you want to do is you want to ask them when you can contact them. If you get 100 responses, you can sort it by date and contact all the people based on the dates that they selected. And if you use the field type called date, it will give the user a date picker, and then that way their response will give you a valid date. So if they misspell a month or type in a day that doesn't exist, they can't do that when you use this option. So this will give you a good date that comes through when you look at your responses. And then you want a way to contact them. And the best way to do that is to come up to the gear icon in the upper right-hand corner and just left-click on collect email addresses. Click save. If you don't want to do it that way, you can always just add another field, collect a phone number, street address, whatever you want. But now we're ready to build the logic into this form. So after the first one, once they tell you what type of course do you want next, you need to select this question. Left click on the three dots, and you want to go to a section based on the answer. So this drop down below is going to take you somewhere just after the entire section. You don't want that. You need to be up here. And for time management, you need to take them to time management courses. For human resources, human resources. And for other, you want to take them down to the other. So that takes care of this first section. If they make their way to time management courses, let's activate this question. When you look at these, if you were to choose where to go for each one of these questions, it'd actually all be the same place because you're ready to just bring them down to the follow-up. So for this section, you can select it from the bottom and just bring them directly down to follow-up no matter what they say. Same thing for human resources. And the same thing for other. And then when they come down to follow-up, they're going to be automatically at the end of the form and they'll click submit. So this is a great way to give the respondents to the survey a better experience because they won't have to go through questions that aren't relevant for them. And it will help to decrease the amount of people that abandon your form because they don't want to fill it all out. And if you want to see more videos just like this one, please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.